Clint got the mulcher. So now I got Chris over there with the mini X pulling stuff out. He's way over there. So we got piles where they used mini X's. No, they didn't use mini X, they used a tractor. So we're cleaning up, goodness, cleaning up all this. So this driveway, so it's 40 acre lot right here, but we're just cleaning this up so that way you'll have this cleaned up. And then there's a barn right, oh, see, yep, barn right there. We're cleaning just a little bit behind it, but we're cleaning all this right here back behind it, because it thins out on the back side of this creek a little bit. All right, well, got a bunch of it cleaned up for the mulcher to come in. There's a ditch right here, but there's a ditch here and there's a ditch on the other side, so that doesn't help. And all of that, picked up some barbed wire. I'm glad to find it with this, not the machine. Looks like it's wrapped around the, it's vice versa. There's a piece of metal. Chris is over here mulching the other side from this side after lunch. So we're trying to follow the property line, but also what they want. And so kind of open it up. So this is what it used to look like. Now we got it going this way, clean it up. On the Mini X, see, they've got a pond here that feeds another pond that feeds another pond. Or all the first one up there feeds, because that's where Chris is at, over there, way over there. So all the ponds, well, there's several beavers in here. And of course, you're gonna, I mean, this is a deep drop off. I mean, a couple semis could sit in here, not even be seen. But of course, this is a snake habitat. So we're gonna pull all this privet stuff, and then we're gonna make piles so that way the mulcher can come in. And so we're gonna scrape it, make it look a little cleaner, but also pull all these trees out right here off the embankment, or out of the embankment. So I'm gonna do this, and then I've got some of them, some of the roots pulled up, and I'll do that all the way down. So clean up some of this stuff, like little privet that's overhanging. So that's where he just went. Now he's going over here to clean this up. So we're just kind of cleaning it up, just a little small saplings, anything overhanging. So this is the aftermath and the finish. It has rained off and on for the past 2 or 3 days, so it's pretty damp. And pine needles, a little bit of dirt, and some small chips. So it shouldn't take long, but no, that's a nice clean finish. He's going that way, so I mean, you can just tell now how nice it's going to be, because the property line shoots straight up and it shoots down that way, but it's creek bed, so it's kind of hard to mulch a creek. But then we made an entrance through here, so we just took the least path resistant, kind of comes up and curls, and then it goes straight from there after this. Well, we got this cleaned up a little bit, kind of scraped the corners, the edges. Then we got this. Plucked everything out, put it to the side, and he mulched it. Now you can see the creek. That hurt if you fell. But look at that. Look at the finish. Pretty good, because he came here with his tractor grapple and it made big old chunks. So I came in and kind of scraped it up a little bit, so that way the water will drain off a little better than it was. But I'm not sure if he wants me to get all this right here or not.